Hello, I think we're live now. Welcome! I'm Narnach and I'm playing Rise of Venice, the medieval trade simulation set around the Mediterranean Sea. This is the second playthrough. I already played through for about 3 hours last time. And we've made a bit of progress. We have a our original fleet here, the Gamma fleet, consisting of a frigate and a bark ship. We have another fleet, the Isali, with a brig and a sloop in it. And I remember something about having a third fleet with some larger boats that unfortunately got killed by pirates in the Constantinople area. And it looks like Thessaloniki is suffering an earthquake. Yes, it's suffering an earthquake, which is not very good. But I think that also means trade opportunity. I mean, earthquake means devastation, means starvation, means they will probably appreciate getting grains and other building materials. Also, we got some money, and we were looking for map fragments. Ah, yes, and the last of the map fragments was hidden somewhere in front of the coast here. There. But in order to get there, we needed to pass by Constantinople, which is being sort of protected by pirates. So this is not the place we can get through until we actually have a better fleet. So that means just accumulating more wealth, rising the ranks, which we can actually do now. Venice, Senate. Yeah, the worst supporter is 61%. Should be able to do something with that. So let's see. Advancement. Let's start. We should fly through this without too much issues. Oh, you may also notice I'm using a different setup from last time. I've got my headset now and a webcam. Because just using the webcam sound, it worked, but the audio sounded a bit weird and of a lower quality than when recording using the headset. So, today I'm recording with the headset on and the webcam on and just see how it goes. I mean, I'm relatively new at this, so I'm just still experimenting to see what works and what works not. And we've upgraded them. We can now have 4 convoys, and Pisa sends us a trading license. That's nice. We already had a trade license, didn't we? Or was it only for Rome and not for Pisa? Let's see. He's got a mission.
What there's something does my the mission family would
entail?
Like.
Mission, yes. Build a warehouse in a Genoese city. Okay, so that's gonna be Rome or Pisa or there's a city below Rome. Naples, of course, Naples. That should reward in a bunch of clothing and some reputation. Well, that works. We can expand our trade routes a bit. I mean, there's bound to be different materials on supply here. I mean, for example, Rome has meat. I know that to produce meat, you need salt, which Venice produces. The wine is nice to bring back to Venice. So we could do a Rome-Venice type of deal, maybe with a stop in the other city we've got along the way and then make a nice triangle. That could work. I see opportunity there for just a then we will have a trade loop here and in the Venice area, got one around Greece and then a final one between Venice and let's say Rome. Okay, so happy with that. Oh, they gave us a limited time, of course. So that's about 6 weeks-ish. Okay, Okay, well, the game is paused, so we can do a little bit of scouting. Okay. Okay, Rome has wine, which we can bring to Venice, because we can't make it. The bricks, we can also just ferry up and down. Metal production. It's fine, we don't need a lot in Venice, but a little bit we can use. Maybe we're not producing tools or anything. We do that in Ragusa. We also have a trade post in Ragusa, don't we?
Greetings.
Yes.
Everything is going as planned.
Okay, so the metal from Rome we can bring to Ragusa. That's also fine. And at some point the salt will boost the output for meat, which is going to be useful. Okay, so we can set up a nice triangle there. So let's see if we can get a small fleet together. Wait, there's a Digama here. What's the plan for that one? It has a trade route. Okay, so it's just still going. That's good. So we have the Digama and we have the Isali, and they're both doing their routes. So that should be fine. Then we can just have a look at Venice and see what we can buy. Ships wise. So a Dow with 400 barrels would be nice. Let's see, 44,000, 43,000, and a little bit, so that's almost 44. Okay, let's see.
Welcome
is there
back.
Anything in the warehouse that we
Strangely
can sell?
Enough, things could
some
hardly
hemp?
Be better.
That's it. Oh wow. And that's probably already at market prices. Okay. So, just going to increase speed again to normal speed. And then have a look. Once we got... just increase it a bit. Okay, we have enough money to buy a boat now. Let's buy the cheap one. Ido. Then we can form a fleet. The Nautilus. Sure, why not? So this is for now, we'll leave it as an unarmed convoy. Okay, planned route. Venice, that's where we start. Then we go to Ragusa.
A trade route is inefficient.
Then we go to Rome. And we'll just make that circle. We'll make it very, very to the point. Okay, then we need to set up the trade, do manual trade. Quantity of goods, everything into the warehouse, that's a good first step. Then selling everything else to the city, that also works for regular prices. Works as well. Then we load up to 100 back out of the warehouse, and then we buy up to 100 from the city at again at going rates. That we can repeat. No, wait, actually for now let's limit this to 50 for the cities where we are established, because there's a chance that we will be loading things from the warehouse already, and this way we don't stuff ourselves with just one material. We can evaluate later how this goes, and then we activate it. Okay, so this is our current mission, that's good. Highlighted. Let's see. Any tips? Ah, okay. Just where we can find it again. Okay, so we have a Nautilus on its way to Ragusa. Which carries with us a grand total of 1. Okay, I'm already sensing a flaw in the plan. We don't actually produce anything yet in our cities. So buying from the cities is actually going to be relatively important at first, because the things we put in the city, it's going to be redistributed back to the city at mostly at market rates. So let's see how this goes. And we're kind of financially constrained.
Welcome back. But strangely enough, lightly. Things.
Okay, so this one has some materials. Ah, we have a captain that leveled up. It's already a master trader. Let's keep boosting the cannoneer aspect. Okay, so Isali is carrying a lot of materials. This one is carrying limited amounts, and we still have some money left. That's positive. Isali sold some stuff, bought some stuff. Still, we have a nice amount of money in stock. Let's see what Rome is doing. Rome is burning. Fire in the city. We need a lot of wood. That's actually already interrupt our very first trip and go to Naples. And sell what we got. We can do that at a decent profit as well. And let's see how much wood we can get. We can load up full of wood. That's good. Then we go to Rome and set it. Build up some extra reputation. Yeah, so unloading most of this is bound to boost reputation. Yeah, about that. Reputation. We need reputation, right? So now they want grain, they want citrus, they want pottery. They want a whole bunch of stuff. We have 4 weeks left to do it. Okay, can buy more of this. We can buy a little bit more of that. And bricks are also just constrained. City info. City hall. Yeah, we need to have a 45% popularity, and we need licensing fees. Joy! Ah, okay, we still have a lot of wood in our storage. Okay, let's see. We have a location that produces grains. I think we can trade in Palermo and Syracuse, but we can go to Coroni, Athens, and get some grains here. Okay, make a slight profit. Looks like they want a bunch of wood in Coroni, so we can just load up. Full ship. Oh, they don't produce wine there, so that's bound to be useful. Okay, and move over to Coroni. Let's see, we can sell a whole bunch. Almost 300 units, that works. Buy some more of this, see how much grain we can get from the city. Okay. Pottery. Some salt. That's all they're producing. Let's see, store some value in ammunition and other weapon types. Leave this as a standalone. That's why if we dock in a harbor, we can just sell the items we need for some cash, but it also prevents the other ships from using it. That's why we reserve some money for when we want to actually use it ourselves. Wait, screw Naples. We're going to Rome. We want a reputation here. We don't really care about Naples. which is a reasonably decent strategy. Okay, bought the stuff. Again, we made a profit here, so store about half of it in weapons. That sounds about right. So that's 7,000. I think the other one is also 7,000. So we got 14,000 already stored, which is not bad. Really, really not bad. Yeah. Almost fully load with wood. Oh, hey, there's some salt, there's some honey. Honey is also useful. Okay, and we're fully loaded again. Let's see, do a quick drop off and then go straight towards Kroni. Wow, they're overloaded on wood. Forty-4%. Oh man. Wow.
It's good to
and
see.
And that's 45% we needed. Okay, yes. Okay. Naples is our supplier of wood. Genoa kind of hates our guts. Let's make the long, long trek to Kroni. Who suddenly decides they want fruits. Okay, they do have a use for wood. Sold about 100. Rome wants grains, so we buy grains. Which there are not a lot of. Okay, let's buy a whole tree of them. Pottery also works. Salt works. Yes, and that's it. We can overspend a little bit on the grains, knowing that Rome has a shortage, Naples has a shortage, and the boat is full. We stored a lot of value here. Let's capture it again. 10,000. Another 7,000. Bring some sailors aboard. We go back towards Rome, not Naples. Rome. 3rd of December. Still got 2.5 weeks left for our mission. Okay, reputation decayed by 2 points. And they like us now. Okay. So, we talk to Rome. City Hall.
It's good to see you.
Yes, 50,000 is what we need, right? So, pause the game. Yes, it's paused now. Then we sell all our armaments to the city. Load up an extra sailor. We've got 73,000 now. And then we can go back to City Hall.
It's good to see you.
Purchase this. And then we can just build a warehouse. And that was enough to fulfill the quest. And we can load it back to normal speed again. And we can activate the route. Make this a more experienced trader. And have a look
back at
our steward.
Strangely enough. Things could hardly be better.
What did we do in... Let's see, let's take Venice. Okay, so we have a transfer limit of 50 on all the things we import, so the ship doesn't take it back, so we can sell it to the city. All the things we produce, we keep a limit of 50, so the city can't take it, but the ships can. Okay, but the theory being that we produce stuff, always guarantee a certain minimum that is available for the ships to pick up, and the rest we can just sell to the city, and once the city starts overflowing, the ships can pick up the rest. Okay, we should be 120, 115. So we buy at 115. Buy, sell. We don't produce anything yet. Okay. This we can just up to 150 points. Then we clear the things we produce. This one we produce. This one we produce. And that one we produce. Okay, fair enough. Then in return we up this to 50, we up that to 50, that to 50, that to 50, and that to 50. That means we have a basic system set up. Okay, yeah. Okay, so wine. What is it we need for that? No, wait, first let's see if we can just build some houses. Yeah, but our working capital is on the low side. I think I will actually wait a little bit, increase our working capital a bit.
Rome is in trouble.
And maybe get Coroni into the mix. Coroni, do we have a warehouse? No, Coroni is not ours. Athens? No, it's, oh well, it's all the way in Thessaloniki. Which means we don't have anything yet that produces grain. Okay, what's our reputation in Coroni? 99%. Might be a good next city to settle in Coroni, so we have a really good point from where to start producing tons of grain and feed the Mediterranean. We can get rich off just feeding the entire Mediterranean. The Isali leveled again. Maximum cannoneer. Good. I'm hearing cannons. Why am I hearing cannons? Okay. Heard something, but I'm not seeing it. Let's take that as a positive for now. Wait, actually, plan route, you, add Coroni to the mix, and then after Ragusa, go to Coroni, and Coroni can just copy all the settings. Yes. Okay, cool. Oh, wait! We had a volcano explode. This is not looking too good for the people in Palermo and Syracuse. Okay. So that was what I heard. It wasn't a cannon, it was a volcano exploding. Yeah. Sucks to be them, I would say. Oh wow, enough already for the Grand Merchant.
Venice is in trouble.
Venice is in trouble. Oh, incurring storage costs. Yeah,
would
of course,
like
because we
rest?
Put a lot of wood
there is nothing to
in
do.
There. Oh no, we want the clothing. We're not selling the clothing just yet. That seems curious. Oh, because we can't actually trade it yet. Oh wow, that's nasty. So we have a bunch of dead weight storage space here. That's not cool. Wonder why they gave us that mission with that reward. Knowing that the game mechanics just prevent us from doing something with it. So we have the gamma, which supposedly is inefficient. So what are its settings for trading? We start in Venice, we try to put everything in a warehouse, and we sell things to the city, which doesn't really do all that well. And we load 100 barrels out of the warehouse again. We buy 50 from the city. We have a storage capacity of 430. Okay, we can probably bump this to 100. And then in Zagara we can just adopt all values. And then we trade more. There's no point in having two ships in the fleet if you're only loading one of them. So what's the Italy doing? Making a small profit? What can we do here to help? Oh, this one had a bigger route. It went all the way up and down from Thessaloniki, Athens, Koroni, Candia, and then back again. So, Thessaloniki. We put everything in the warehouse. We sell everything to the city. Load 100 from the warehouse, and then we buy 50 from the from the city. If we increase that to 100 as well, and just apply that across the board. Okay, let's see. How is our Thessaloniki warehouse doing?
Greetings. Probably everything is going as planned.
Relatively empty. That's good. That means we're not buying too much stuff. Can't actually get rid of anywhere. Yeah, okay, so now we bought 62 pottery instead of the fixed 50 we would normally be kept at. Bypass the pirate there. 80 grain, which is good since everybody wants grain. No! Okay, zooming has some. Oh, we were barely escaping. Barely escaping. Yes. Go, go, go. That's the downside, of course. If we load more stuff on board, we have more issues with pirates. And we really need a third ship. Can we? Okay, so they actually don't produce anything in Thessaloniki. Seriously, they don't produce anything in Thessaloniki. At 20,000, but the city needs to be bigger. Okay, that's fair, I suppose. They produce a lot of wood, which the other other cities like, up to and including Candia. Okay, so Koroni bought all the wood.
A trade route is inefficient.
That's not this one, right? No, this is making a 10,000 profit. Sweet. Okay, so bigger ship works. Nautilus, how are you doing today? Making a loss. Okay, I have to go back to you. The Gamma. Also making a loss. I see. Okay, so Nautilus, what are you doing? Is it just a bad start? Okay, so none of these three countries produces wood. But we're going via Koroni, which also doesn't produce wood. So this is not something that drives wood around, even though most of these cities would like some wood. In fact,